Good evening, my friends, family, and colleagues. I appreciate sharing this occasion with all of you, all around the globe. I appreciate a lot of you coming from outside Houston and outside Texas and outside the US to come and share this occasion with me. For that, I am very grateful. And I hope, you know, that I will see you here, and I am very joyful to be here. And my thanks is for the Engineering News Record, great magazine that affected a lot of engineers, scientists, and others all around the world. My thanks for Scott Sells, Jan Tuckman, and Scott Blair. And my special thanks for a lady that she worked very hard on this. Her goal was to help people in air quality and to engineer also solution for air quality, to work with us, engineer and scientists and other. She put a lot of time from her and a lot of effort. For that, I am forever grateful. She's a great journalist, and you know, ENR got to be very lucky to have somebody like her. And I am very appreciative. And for that, I salute you, Nadine Post. I look forward to see you in person. This award is a great honor for me. And I appreciate and thank the people that came before me for this award, like Vicki O'Leary, Chris LeBon, and the 25 finalists that I learned about them and I admire them. My thanks for all of them, and my thanks and appreciation for the Engineering News Record. These 25 newsmakers, they are great people to be one of them, okay, and I'm very honored with this. Today, my thanks is for my family and for MediStar team that helped me, and IVP, and for Glenda Perryman, that she has been an inspiration for me in this invention and other. My very special thanks today for Dr. Garrett Peel, Dr. Zia Ren, University of Houston Superconductivity Lab, that was led by Dr. Paul Chu, a great physicist, a great scientist behind the superconductivity and Nobel Prize nominee. I was very honored, and I am very honored to work with them. Also, my special thanks for Chancellor John Sharp of University of Texas A&M, okay, and Dr. Kathy Banks. They both, with their help, that really helped me a great deal on taking this invention and to a reality. And with their scientists and with their professor, I'm very honored to work with you, Texas A&M, to work with you, Dr. Kathy Banks. You are a great scientist and you are a great person. And my thanks to Dr. Sebastian Pressler, director of the National Lab in Galveston, that him and his scientists put a lot of time and energy to in the lab to check our invention. Their contribution is very important to us. With that, I want today to address a few important things, in my opinion, on this invention. This invention is based on science. It's based also on hard work and creativity. This science, we need to have and work with it, because our situation now, after 560,000 people dead in our nation and millions of people outside, it's really, you know, moved me very much to do more of this and advance this invention to another level. And this is what I'm working on too. And I don't have all the answer. I need people to help me. I need other scientists. I need other engineers. That's why Engineering News Record is very important to us in the United States and around the globe, because it gives people knowledge about what's going on. This is what we need. We need to be prepared for future, another virus. Vaccine made me feel very good, very safe. It's a positive step in our nation. But besides vaccine, we need something else, because there is a lot of unknown thing. Unknown what kind of virus we're going to be hit next, because we were surprised by this virus. It took us by surprise, by shocks, by not knowing about it, by guessing. The time for guessing and all of this is gone. We cannot afford another situation like this. We need to be on the offense. We need to be prepared. We need the government with us. This is a disaster. You know, we need science, and we need an institute. I will launch this institute myself to help and work with other scientists. This institute will be a non-for-profit institute and supported by others, supported by government, supported by scientists. But the time is of the essence. We have only time to fight. Every minute count and every hour count. People depend on us, and I will do everything in my life, everything in my power, everything I have to fight and find solution and work with others, because I need others, people to help. I need other brain. And we have a lot of good people to help us. Today, my call is for our engineer, contractor, construction company, architect, and scientist is to raise the standard of indoor quality of air and to find ways around to purify the air. HVAC system is very important to advance it in our building. It's airborne. This is what IVP also came with the idea of this invention. And IVP, our invention, all of us, okay, it's very important, you know, for this. This is not only for us, this is around the globe. You have a great contractor, great engineer, great physicist, and we need to work together all. This is a call for help, not only from the government, from other people and other engineering company, construction company, architect, scientist. We like to work all together to help our people. We need help. We need to be united. Everybody is precious now. Every idea is important. We need that. And I will appreciate if you can help me in starting an institute of advancing science. And advancing science not only in this, but going to higher standard of air quality in buildings that we inhale, that we live with, and also higher science to kill this virus and other viruses that we don't know about. Thank you very much. May God bless all of you and protect you and guide us for a better future, for this will not happen to us again.